It's challenging to be bold sometimes, especially as a woman in tech as well. I'm excited about augmentation devices. Obviously, that's kind of my what I do during my day. I'm Dani Clode. I'm a designer. I design augmentation devices and upper limb prosthetics for neuroscience research. So my main project is called the third thumb. It's an extra robotic thumb controlled with your toes. Yeah, we're seeing these devices more and more. Humans are always interested in expanding ourselves, our mind, our bodies. And we're seeing these augmentation devices popping up. But we want to make sure that we're not impacting the biological body too much. By extending our physical body, we want to check that the brain is still, you know, happy to do this, that we're not taking something away from the brain in order to then extend ourselves. So our research is we're exploring how the brain responds to augmentation for the future. I've spoken to a surgeon who's interested in the third thumb because it's really interesting to expand the function of the hand. So tasks that are done with two hands could perhaps be performed with one hand. Tasks that are done with a partner, with a collaborator, for example in surgery, could be done by one person but while expanding the biological body. But if we're using augmentation devices at that level, you know, every day for years of our working life, is that going to impact our biological body in a way that could be perhaps, you know, dangerous? We don't know if we're doing this research now. We want to find out now. So I'd like to you know, see a future where this kind of technology that's wearable is just expanding anybody's body, and that we don't talk about them as augmentation or prosthetics, and really exploring it in a you know, positive fashion way as well. You know, everyone deserves to kind of wear something that's beautiful that they choose to wear, and that's what I try to do with my prosthetic arm designs. I collaborate with the Alternative Limb Project, and we're really trying to push the boundaries of prosthetic design and ask questions about the future architecture of our bodies. People underestimate multidisciplinary collaboration a lot. Innovation is really incredible when you have all these different people come together to for one kind of goal. Even, you know, the tools that I use, you know, the 3D printing devices and you know, materials that I use are because someone else innovated those specific tools that enable me to do my job. So it's just this kind of, you know, collaborative process to innovate to lead to kind of one goal, which I think is exciting. It's challenging to be bold sometimes, especially as a woman in tech as well. You know, you just have to keep pushing forward with your vision. I think a bold step for myself, it was, you know, moving from New Zealand to the UK, to London, very different world, and that in turn enabled me to go to the Royal College of Art, where I created the third thumb, which is now my main project that I work on and I've been working on since 2017. So yeah, these kind of bold steps definitely led to where I am today, and also the third thumb is quite a weird design that a lot of people asked a lot of questions about when I first created it. I felt bold in order to kind of keep pushing and still kind of keep asking those questions, which has led to this exciting research.